Hey guys, Old Radio Al here. Time for another mishmash. I've had a successful YouTube afternoon. Found four new channels to subscribe to. Not new channels, but new to me. The first one is D-Man. Or Demand. I don't know. But anyway, he has a series of short videos, average probably about 4 or 5 minutes in length. And he has a ton of them up, as you can see. And he demos all of these radios. Quite a few of which look very familiar to me for some reason, like that one. Anyway, that one too. Yeah. And that one. Anyway, he's got a lot of nice radios here. You ought to check them out. Oh, I'll be darned. There's another one. Anyway. Take a look. Some nice radios. And then after that, I was going through my subscriber list. And I ran across a few guys that I didn't know about. One is Dan O'Connor. And Dan has quite a few videos up also of all different kinds of vintage electronics stuff. A little bit of everything. So I'll check him out too. And this one, I think I've seen videos of his before, and I don't know, for some reason I never subscribed, which I'm doing as we speak. Vintage coin op. A lot of jukeboxes and video games and just all kinds of things. Mickey. His name's Mickey. And he's got a lot of subscribers. He's got over 1,000 subscribers himself. But that's a channel I didn't know about, so if you didn't know about it, might want to give it a look. Some really cool stuff. And last but not least, Amberola 1B. And he's got a lot of cool stuff too. A lot of old records and recordings. Love this kind of stuff, as I know most of you do too. OTR stuff. So I just thought I'd mention that, and also say, guys, if you're posting videos and you haven't seen me comment on anything, oh, I need to subscribe to that one too. You haven't seen me comment before, it probably means I haven't seen your videos, so leave me a message so I can check your channel out. You know, I'm not promising I'll subscribe, but chances are, if you've got a lot of cool stuff like this, I will be. And sometimes it's not easy to find things on YouTube, you know. So let me know, guys. And now let's look at some other stuff. I feel obligated to show you this thing, guys. I showed it to you a long time ago in unrestored condition. Well, he's done some work on it. I'm in my favorite antique store again. This is an Atwater Kent Keel Table 55C 1929 model. It's a table radio. And he had it restored. The speaker sits down into it. There's the chassis. Chassis just sitting in there. It's not bolted in or anything. They were too heavy for that. But it's a table and it's a radio. Pull the front panel down and there's your radio. He had this thing gone over and restored. Didn't do a great job on the table portion, but that's fixable. I would buy this if I had room and I wasn't going to start downsizing soon. $175, that's good price. See any problems with veneer. Just need to refinish the tabletop, really. Really cool. He brought this thing in too. And I would buy that if I, again, 5 years ago I would have bought this in a heartbeat, put all my caps and resistors in. Was $45, Greg. Fair amount of rust, but it's all there. Or a speaker. That's an FM modulator. Immediately post World War II, I imagine. Yep, 1948. You had a AM radio with a RCA input. You could plug that in and have FM. Wooden cabinet. That's odd. Most of them are Bakelite. A couple of cool things. This is a farm radio. I've never heard of this El Tatro
some Cub Scout crystal set. Has a plug on it, but it's DC only. One other cool thing. This is a Midland unusual set. Unusual GE. I don't think I've ever seen one like that. Pretty rough shape. It's a rainy Saturday morning. Knocked my internet out. I thought I'd show you a radio real quick. I know I haven't shown this one before. It's a small little guy. It's an Emerson. Either a 1952 or a 1953, depending on which model it is. Tag on the bottom says it's a 707. However, the 707s were the Starburst. Had a Starburst pattern on the grill. The 737 from a year later had this type of grill. So either this, I don't know, it could be one of three things. Either Radio Museum could be wrong. The label could be wrong. Every time I kiss somebody new, or it's a combination of two radios. The grill's been replaced. Possible. Who knows? At any rate. Each night is light. Nice little radio. Very directional. Pretty subject to noise, too. But it's just so darn cute. Each night. Oh yeah, by the way. Dinah, if she wandered to China, I would hop an ocean liner just to be with Dinah Lee. Finally found a place where my talking house transmitter works pretty well without much noise. So now there are two in the house. theoretically, I could keep switching back and forth. At bay. Anyway, thought I'd show you this little guy real quick. Here's a little guy. Look at that. Keepy John is as big as that radio. For any new viewers that don't know who Keepy John is, you'll have to go back. Wifey was right, John. Keepy John looks just like you. All right, guys. Just thought I'd show you that radio real quick.
Say, Grandpa. Grandpa. I'm Batman. Oh, is that right? Can you tell me? Tell me what you've been doing. You've been out fighting crime? Say, yes, I do, because I'm Batman.
One of those made in India reproductions. Be careful, guys. Don't be fooled.
Radio.
Little Admiral. $8. Huh. Zenith clock.
All clocks.
A GE. Two GEs. All of them cheap. $8. I like that animal best. Kind of cool looking little silver tone clock radio. Too much though. Missing a knob, it'd be easy to find. Must be clock radio day. Nice. 22.50. Not bad. Oh, but look at that. Missing the handle. There's a Westinghouse. $55. Not bad shape. Not bad at all. It's kind of a different consulate. This is the Fisher. It's got a grand four-speed turntable in it. Philharmonic AM/FM. Pink painted RCA, somebody's very proud of. $90. What the heck, it lights up. It's in good shape, just like that paint job. It's complete. Easy restore.
Gracias, profesor. Rosita, ¿es esto un lápiz?
Sí, profesor. Esto es un lápiz.
Raúl, ¿es esto una pluma?
No, profesor. Esto no es una pluma. Es un lápiz.
Came home yesterday to find this package, and the package had a note in it. The note says, "Al, I found these at one of my favorite stores and immediately thought of you. If you listen to them once or twice, I'm sure you'll be fluent in no time. Sincerely, your thoughtful buddy, Art." And in the package, this set of Spanish for Secondary Schools, First Level, Part 1, Student Practice Records, Audio, Lingual, Visual, Spanish. Full set of them. They're 33 and a thirds. Obviously, playing on the Philco M15. How cool is that? Not only Spanish lessons, vintage Spanish lessons. Just amazed at how thoughtful. Well, you said it right there, your thoughtful buddy Art. So how thoughtful people can be. I'm sure Art's tongue was a bit in his cheek, but nonetheless, it's pretty cool. So I'm going to go back to listening. And that's going to wrap this one up, guys. As always, thanks for watching. More stuff on the way.